I welcome you all in the e-practical demonstration of calculation of pharmacokinetic parameters of drug using semi-logarithmic graph paper. It is a very important topic in the subject of biopharmaceutics and pharmacokinetics of classes 1 to 4th year and B.Pharm 6th semester. So let us start with the concept of pharmacokinetic studies. Pharmacokinetics is the study of kinetics of absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion of drugs and their corresponding pharmacological, therapeutic or toxic responses in man and animals. Its applications are bioavailability measurement, effect of physiological and pathological conditions on drug disposition and absorption, dosage adjustment of drugs in disease states, evaluation of drug interactions, clinical prediction using pharmacokinetic parameters to individualize the drug dosing regimen and thus provide the most effective drug therapy. So, pharmacokinetic models are used for the evaluation of pharmacokinetic parameters. A model is a hypothesis that employs mathematical terms to concisely describe quantitative relationships. And pharmacokinetic models provide concise means of expressing mathematically or quantitatively the time course of drug throughout the body and compute meaningful pharmacokinetic parameters. So let us take the example of one compartment open model for the following drug which is administered via intravenous bolus administration. The particular model can be described diagrammatically using this diagram in which this particular one box represents the whole body and other body constituents. This elimination rate constant, this is first order elimination rate constant by which the drug is being eliminated out from the body. And the general expression for rate of drug presentation to the body is dx by dt is equals to rate in minus rate out. This can be written as dx by dt is equals to minus kex, where x is the first order, ke is the first order elimination rate constant and x is the amount of drug present in the body at any time t. There will be the no term regarding rate in, that is availability of the drug, as in one compartment open model intravenous bolus administration, the absorption process is bypassed. Upon integrating above, we get the final equation, that is lnx is equals to lnx naught minus ket, where x naught is the initial amount of the drug administered. Following parameters can be calculated. First one is initial drug concentration, that is represented by C naught. Second is first order elimination rate constant, that can be represented by ke. Third important pharmacokinetic parameter is elimination half-life, that can be represented by T half. Fourth one is volume of distribution, that is Vd. And fifth one is clearance, total systemic clearance, that is Clt. So for the first parameter, that is elimination rate constant, the above equation shows that the disposition of drug follows one compartment kinetic is mono exponential. So we can write the initial equation as x is equals to x naught e raised to power minus ket, and converting into logarithmic form and using the relationship between x, that is amount of drug, and c, that is concentration of drug present in the body, that is x is equals to vd into c, we can get the equation log c is equals to log c naught minus ket upon 2.303, where c naught is the initial plasma drug concentration achieved after administration of IV bolus drug, c is the concentration of drug present in the body at any time t, while ke is the first order elimination rate constant. So this equation, that is log c is equals to log c naught minus ket upon 2.303, can be compared with the straight line equation, that is y is equals to mx plus b, where y is the variable on y axis, that is concentration or log concentration. B is the y intercept which gives the value of C naught, while x is the variable on x axis, that is time, and m is the slope of the particular straight line. So now calculation of pharmacokinetic parameters, and the objective of this demonstration is a case study of a drug following one compartment open model administered by IV bolus route. First step of this practical is data collection, in which the drug whose parameter has to be estimated can be administered. For example, 600 mg single intravenous dose of ampicillin was given to an adult whose weight is 70 kg. His blood samples were taken periodically and analyzed, and following plasma concentration versus time profile was obtained. So at different time intervals, that is at 1 hour, then 2nd, 3rd and 5th hour, blood samples were taken, and the evaluated plasma drug concentration is 37 microgram per ml, 21.5 microgram per ml, 12.5 and 4.5 microgram per ml respectively. Then second step of the demonstration is data interpretation. So for following this equation, that is log C is equal to log C naught minus KET upon 2.303, we have to plot log C versus T plot. Means log C has to be plotted on the y axis and time has to be plotted on x axis. So the obtained data is converted into its logarithmic form, and each plasma drug concentration value is can be converted into its log form. And when this time versus log plasma drug concentration graph is plotted, a straight line can be achieved. But this particular method is tedious and associated with less precision. Thus, there is an alternative method which is much more accurate and precise than that method, is semi-log graph method. A semi-log or semi-logarithmic graph or plot has one axis on a logarithmic scale and the other on a linear scale, as you are seeing on the screen. This is an example of semi-log graph paper. This is particularly useful for the data with exponential relationship. For example, the equation x is equals to x naught e raised to power minus kT, or c is equal to c naught e raised to power minus kT. So now the most important part of this demonstration is how to plot a semi-log graph. So first of all, have a look at this semi-log graph paper. This semi-log graph paper has equally distributed vertical lines, but the distribution of horizontal lines is not equal. It actually represents the logarithmic scale at the y-axis. As we are representing it as a semi-log graph paper, so semi-log means the one side of x-axis is a simple graph paper, while the y-axis has log axis. The point of origin in general graph is generally 0, but here you are saying it is 1. Means the y-axis has this terminal value 1, while the x-axis has this terminal value 0. But in actual, if we deep understand it, this value is also 0, because the value of log 1 is 0. Now this scale, as you see, this you are seeing is this graph, this is divided into 4 equal parts. Like this particular portion is superimposable to this particular portion, and this portion, and this portion. Now see the coordinates of this y-axis. These values can be read as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 10 raised to power 1. 10 raised to power 1 means 10, and log of 10 is 1, while this log 1 is 0. Then this value will be read as 20, not 12. 10, then 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and up to 10 raised to power 2, that is 100, and log 100 is, we know that it is 2. Then similarly, after 100, it will be 200, 300, 4, 5, 7 up to 1000, and log value of 1000 is 3. Similarly, 2000, 3000 up to 10 raised to power 4, that is 10,000, and log value of 10,000 is 4. So this particular graph is divided into 4 portions, that is from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. And ultimately we can say that the y-axis is also distributed equally. Now the first step to plot this semi-log graph paper, first of all we have to learn the right direction of this graph. Always use the graph in this way, means we have to take the y-axis as this particular value, this particular
axis, and this will be y axis. If you take the graph like this or like this, this will be the wrong position for plotting the semi-log graph paper. Always the y axis value will start from 1 to in ascending order. So the first step of the graph is to label the y axis, that is in our case the y axis is time, that is in hours, and the y axis is plasma drug concentration . The units are microgram per ml. So in this case we are plotting a graph between time and plasma drug concentration. So the example which we are taking is the different time intervals. We have taken the blood samples and the plasma concentration at first hour was 37. So we will plot a point at first hour. We have taken 2 cm is equal to 1 hour. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now for plotting the value of plasma drug concentration at 1 hour, that is 37, we will plot at the 1 value 2, this is 10, then 20, 30, this is 35 and this is 37. So we can label it as y axis is 37 and x axis is 1. At the second point, the value is 21.5. As precise as we will plot the graph, the more accurate results we will get. 21.5 plasma drug concentration at second hour. At third hour, the value of plasma drug concentration is 12.5. So we have plotted 12.5. And at fifth hour, the value is 4.5. So after plotting this graph, we will get a straight line equation. And upon joining this straight line equation and on extrapolating this equation, we will get the value of y intercept. So from this graph, we can read the value of y intercept, that is, it is around 63 microgram per ml, as it is representing the value of initial drug concentration. Means at 0th time, at 0th hour, the drug, when drug has been administered, a rise in initial concentration has been obtained and the value is 63 microgram per ml. So after discussing the semi-log graph paper, we have plotted the semi-log graph paper, and as you have seen, this particular type of graph has been achieved on a semi-log graph paper, from which the initial plasma drug concentration has been obtained equal to 63 microgram per ml. That was our first pharmacokinetic parameter, that is initial plasma drug concentration. Now this particular linear curve which we have got, from this we can calculate the value of slope, which is equal to minus k upon 2.303. So we can take any two points on this curve. For example, this is y1, that is 37, and t1 is 1, and y2, any second point is at time 2. It's plasma, at this point y2 means plasma drug concentration is 21.5. So the slope can be calculated as log y2 minus log y1 upon x2 minus x1, which is equals to minus ke upon 2.303, and it was calculated as minus 0.2236, from which the elimination rate constant, that is first order elimination rate constant, it was found to be 0.543 per hour. Another important pharmacokinetic parameter is elimination half-life. The formula for this is 0.693 upon Ke. Putting the value of Ke into the formula, we can get the value of elimination half-life, and it has came to be 1.3 hours. Another important pharmacokinetic parameter is volume of distribution, which is a hypothetical volume of body fluids into which the drug is being distributed. The formula for calculating VD is X0 upon C0. The X0, that is initial amount of drug that has been administered via IV bolus route, is 600 mg. Converting it into microgram, because the concentration has the units microgram per ml, the value of VD can be computed as 9523.80 ml, or we can say that 9.523 liter. And the
Another important parameter is total systemic clearance, CLT. The formula for calculating clearance is KE, that is elimination rate constant multiplied by volume of distribution. By putting the above values into this, the clearance was found to be 5.17 liter per hour. And the clearance is the hypothetical volume of body fluids from which the drug is being eliminated in a particular period of time or a unit period of time. So, after all computing all these pharmacokinetic parameters, I hope, my dear students, you may be able to solve some other questions also. So, this is a task for you. I am giving you some more questions. That is, how long would it take for 99.9% of this drug to be eliminated? You have to calculate the time in which 99.9% of the dose administered would be eliminated. Another question is, if the minimum effective concentration of drug is 4 microgram per ml, you have to calculate the duration of action for this drug. And another question for you is, if the dose of drug is doubled, means we have in this case study, we have administered the drug as 600 mg. If the dose is doubled, 1200 mg, what would be the effect on duration of activity? So, I hope this demonstration has cleared your many doubts. In further demonstration, surely we will go in more deep and we will discuss many other pharmacokinetic parameters like absorption rate constant, urinary excretion rate constants, etc. So, at the end, I would like to thank the administration and management of ISF College of Pharmacy for providing me the facilities to give you this practical demonstration. I also want to thank my technical team, Ms. Navjot Kaur, Ms. Birpal Kaur, and my student Shubham. For any further questions, you can contact me at the given details.